A very good morning and a warm welcome to all dear students. Students, in the last lecture we all have discussed about the reptiles. In this lecture we will be talking about the apes. So let us talk about the reproductive system in the apes. When I talk about the apes, here we are going to learn about the apes reproductive system with the special reference of the pigeon reproductive system. So reproductive system are when I talk about, so the pigeon are, they are dioecious, that means they have the distinct male and the female. Reproductive mode, they show the internal fertilization. So the internal fertilization we have seen into the previous example also. So it is a mode of the reproduction in which the sperms are directly transferred into the female body. And they are oviparous, that means like reptiles, they lay the egg and that egg are incubated outside the mother's body. And on the basis of the rearing and incubation act showed by the male are selecting their mate. And when I talk about their accessory structure, let us discuss into the detail about the reproductive system in male and female. So male, they have the testes. They have the pair of oval testes. Their testes are located near the kidney. Their testes are enlarged during the breeding season. Do you remember when we were talking about the reptile? That time also I told you that during the breeding season, they get the special changes. They start secreting the pheromones and all. So same here also, their testes are going to enlarge because of the activation of the sperm production, as well as in some other birds who will be getting a reproductive courtship call also. They become, you will see the males are more attractive, more beautiful other birds. In case of the pigeon, you will not see such type of the differences, but in other case of the bird, they show the different act of the courtship. In case of the pigeon also, they show the act of the courtship. The male is attracting the female by showing the parental care behavior. So this is a specific feature in case of the birds. So let's talk about the testes. So we have seen they have the oval-shaped testes, and they get enlarged during the breeding season and produces the sperm as well as secretes the male sex hormones. The testes are attached to the anteroventral end of the kidney, and they are attached by a fold of the peritoneum, that is called as the mesontium. And the duct which carries the sperm from the testes to the cloaca is called as the vasa differentiae. It is a big duct. You can see here into the diagram. This is the vasa differentiae. So you can see as well that this vasa differentiae is running parallel to the ureter. Okay, so it is connected to the testes. And if you see the last part, so the last part is connected. Or you can say it's slightly swollen to form the seminal vesicle. Function of the seminal vesicle is same as the men. That means that it helps the formation of the semen, and their semen function, you know, it adds to the nourishment and the viability and motility of the sperm. So they store the sperm until the part of the ejaculation. Now see, in case of the birds, they lack the phallus. So they have the rudimentary structure for the copulation, that is called as a phallus. And cloaca of both sexes at the time of the intercourse come close, and they facilitate the sperm transfer. Female reproductive system comprises of the ovary. Interestingly, birds have only one ovary. Many birds, they just have only one ovary, and that is the left ovary, and the right ovary get ossified when they become adult. So only one ovary, that is present at the left side. Ovary produces ova as well as the female sex hormone estrogen and progesterone. Ovary is suspended from the dorsal body wall by the mesentery, that is called as the mesovarium. Oviduct, long coiled oviduct is there, that is divided into the region. Do you remember in the case of the other oviparous example, reptiles, we have learned in that also we have seen that they have the divided oviduct. So I misspelled oviduct, it is O-V-I-D-U-C-T. So I forgot to type it, basically. So oviduct, that is divided into the region with a specific function. first part of the ovule is the infundibulum. Now see, in the previous lecture I told you when the ovums are ready or they are mature, so that are released into the body cavity, and from the body cavity they are collected from the ovule. So infundibulum is the part which will help to capture the release ova in the site of the fertilization, as well as the magnum adds the egg white albumin around the yolk. Then next part is the isthmus, which will add the inner and outer shell membrane. Then uterus, there is a shell gland, forms the heart calcareous shell. After that the vagina, which will just facilitating egg to lay down. And the last part is cloaca. Ovule is attached to the dorsal body wall by the broad ligament, that is called as the mesotubarium. Now the reproductive process, cloaca is common cavity for all digestive-based, urinary-based reproductive tract. So it serves the exit point for both. This is an egg in case of male and female. So at the time of the insemination, both the cloaca, both sex cloaca will come closer, that is known as the cloacal kiss. And after that they are laying the egg, fertilized egg internally. And after that egg will travel. See what I told you, when the egg are mature, they are ready, that will be released into the body cavity. So in the body cavity, this sperm will travel, and inside the body cavity only the fertilization of the egg will happen. And after that, the egg will go to the oviduct. Because we have seen in the oviduct what processes are happening, the egg is gaining albumin. So this process happens that first, egg will fertilize internally, and after that, the egg will gain albumin into the magnum, shell membrane into the isthmus, calcareous shell into the uterus. So, all these events will happen, and after that, the egg will be laid from the cloaca, and that will be incubated by both of the parents. Partly, male will incubate, then female will incubate. So both the parent will take care of the egg. So this is all about the reproductive process and reproductive system of the pigeon. If anyone have any doubt, just write down your queries into the comment box. Definitely I am able to answer to it. Thank you very much.